Okay, welcome back to Let's Play Need Speed Underground Tour. In the last part, we did a lot of outrun races and started on stage 3, I believe. And in this part, we'll be doing more races in stage 3. So let's begin with a sprint. And what I'm trying to do is trying to find the races that are actually quite close to each other, so I don't have to drive a lot. But I did say I will skip out the driving scenes if it takes too long. Like, I don't know, if I had to go like to the first city all the way to the third, just for a race. And let's see what we're facing today. A Mustang, a Corolla, and a 106, I believe. So this should be fun. And also, while I'm at it, off-screen I managed to get that unique part. Because the choice was an engine, the gear settings, or I keep forgetting what it's called, and the tyres, and I picked the engine. So that's all I did while I off-screen. And yeah, amazingly, only, I think, one drag race has turned up. Which I'm surprised, because I thought there'd be more drag races, but I'll check on the minimap again, see if the thing hasn't tricked me. I'm pretty sure that I didn't hardly have any drag races. Hang on, I've forgotten. When this race finishes, do you respawn there? No, I haven't really thought this properly. But we're almost there. We almost completed our first race. And I want to try and get away further from these opponents as possible. I think you get more rip if you do that. So we're ahead by 4 seconds. Let's see how much rep this gives us. We got 200, so I think we need to get more. I don't know. Frick it. Frick the rep. I don't know how it works. Yes, we want to overwrite our game data. Right, let's say successful. And one race and it only took 3 minutes. Nice. Hopefully we can try and get a lot of races in as possible. So yeah. This will be good. And also while I'm at it, I think I had a pretty good Christmas. How was yours Christmas, by the way? Let's see, we've got headlights. Is that it? Yep. Oh, we also have ECU as well, level 2. Which is nice. So yeah, I managed to get a couple of games. Pokemon X and Y, that I was actually mainly looking most forward to. I got Mario Kart 7 again. Yeah, it's actually quite a good game. And I think, yeah, I got a Chrome BMW M3 GTR model. The same one from Need for Speed Most Wanted, but instead of the vinyls, it's all just chrome, which is awesome. So, yeah. And right now we are continuing on with Need for Speed Underground Tour. Hopefully trying to get to Need for Speed Most Wanted. But after that I'll see, I don't know. I'll think about, was it Undercover. Undercover's good, it's a good game. There's actually quite a lot of stuff to do. And let me get over the fine. And the long way it is then. So yeah, Undercover is actually quite a good game and has quite an amount of decent cars. Right now I have played that game again. And I want to see it. I tried to go on the online races, but I can't get any races whatsoever. So yeah, I should try and play that again. Maybe at a later time, like Midnight Club. Midnight Club has some online players on it. Midnight Club LA, I'm talking about. Around about 6 o'clock, I'd say I might luckily get a couple of races. Also, I'll try and record some Midnight Club online races. The only problem is if I can actually get any races. Because it's actually quite rare now to get Midnight Club LA. Actually, any races in Midnight Club LA, I'm supposed to say. But, meh. I'll see. I'd say it all depends on what time I go on it. So, I'll try later. See if I can get any online races. Right, and let's see how much rep we're going to get for how far we're going to be ahead. Also, I'll try not to crash into anything. I mean, any traffic-wise, anyway. I want to stay on the this side. And also, I figured out a topic I want to do soon. Well, I want to do a top 10. I've been saying that for about a couple of months now. I really want to do it. But I haven't been thought of a topic, and now I think I may have one. And I want to... One of my topics is my top 10 favorite cars on the list. But I'm still trying to figure... I know what's number 1 and number 2. I'm still trying to figure out what's probably going to be best for where. Because there's actually quite a lot of good cars in these video games. And I just need to figure out what goes where and what goes... What goes where and what cars could I use? Because some cars are good for some certain things, and there's other cars that are good for other things as well. But then there's the cars that really stand out the most, and the cars are kind of cheap, good at the start, but really can handle well towards mainly through the game. I mean, I'm thinking of putting a car on there that is like, you get unlocked at really early in the game, but you can use it until very late of the game when you have unlocked like group Class A vehicles like the Lamborghini Monte Gallardo, which is like really fast. Which is, I say it's a tier 3, I think it's tier 4, and a Lamborghini Monte Gallardo is a tier 1 car. And to be used for 4 tiers is quite damn good, to be honest. I mean, tier 3 and 2, and it got beaten by tier 4. Maybe because of the performance parts as well, and how the races are. Man, I need to actually think about this. So, I know there's... I know there's the Need for Speed games, there's also the Midnight Club games I want to try and get in as well. And also there's other cars as well that from like mainly Hot Wheels series. It could be good, I don't know. No, I want to try and get realistic cars in the series that I want to do for me top 10. I want to try and spread it out evenly as well, so it's like not sort of the same thing. As well. So I say like, I want to add some muscles and exotic cars to it, besides my mainly juniors. I want it like split up evenly. Say like if I had like, I don't know, 3 exotics, 3 muscles and 3 juniors. But there's going to be 1 left over. But that 1 might actually be an exotic or tuner. Because in Need for Speed Carbon it counts as an exotic. But it's also a tier 2 car Need for Speed Undercover. And Need for Speed Carbon, it was a tier 3. And it was pretty hard to get. So yeah. Yeah. So expect the top 10 really soon. But I don't know how much soon though. It'll be like Pokemon Bank. Pokemon Bank is coming soon. And then a little bit later. It's going to be coming more soon. When are we gonna get Pokemon Bank? Nintendo. They released. Okay, with Pokemon X and Y. They got on the deadline, but Pokemon Bank? Yeah. Still waiting for it. They got it in European countries like Japan. and a couple of other places. But any English-speaking territories haven't still got it yet. Which is, I'm kind of a disappointed. But, meh. Oh, well. Can't wait to get it and transfer my Mincino over to X and Y. Actually, no, I could get Mincino by friends. Was it the friend link? I think it's called. After you complete the story. And also, I want other things. I need to research. Because there's a couple of Pokemon that I want to use in X and Y. From Black and White and HeartGold and SoulSilver. Right then, so we've done that. We only have 100 rep. Okay, fair enough. So, we've done that long circuit race. I can't believe that's 3 laps. And that was actually quite a big circuit race as well. Right then, so hopefully now we'll be doing a Street X and then a Star event. And I also want to go to the performance shop as well. So right then, the Star event is there, Street X is there. Oh nice. And the performance shop is just behind us. Fuck it, we're going to the performance shop to add to the new EUC. Actually no, they don't have it in the level 1 performance shop. I swear they don't, because they only have little parts, and that's why it's blocked over here. Right, Street X. Luckily I don't have to drive very far.
Yo, what up, kid? You got any details on rumors of racing in Beacon Hill? Yo, I heard a bunch of punks with more bank than brains. You should be easy picking. If you hear any more, man, check it out and let me know. Peace.
Beacon Hill. Interesting. I don't know why I said that with an accent as well. So let's do it to Street X. I think I know where that could be, but we're going to stick around this area for now. Then hopefully we'll move on to Jackson Heights and then do the races in Jackson Heights. And also we have that URR race as well. So if we complete this really quick, we can head over to the URL race in the airport. Well, we probably weren't going to do this really quick. I bet you we're going to fail, like, somewhere along the line. I feel sorry for the people who actually had to do the start line. They may have a chance of getting run over, though. Like, what we almost did. We almost run over the start line thingy person. Who the hell's in first, anyway? So yeah, I think it looks like a 206. Is it? Yeah, it's 206. Get back here. Ow. So, we all came here to win. And continue on with the process of Need for Speed Underground 2. So we can do Most Wanted. Because Most Wanted is actually quite a fun game. There we are. Done that race. Actually, when I think about it, I actually missed the Honda Civic. The Honda Civic is actually quite a good car, and it's actually only an American version of the Need for Speed Underground 2. I do actually miss it though. For the Civic and the Kerr RX-6, we get the 106 and the Corsa. I'll admit, they're both good cars, but I think they should have added them both, so it's like, even. Like in Need for Speed Underground 2. Okay, so we got nicely rep and points. But anyway, back to that. I wish we could have all the cars, you know, the Acura, the Civic, the Vauxhall, and the 106. I wonder if there's a limited edition of this game. Huh. Like what Need for Speed Carbon did. Need for Speed Carbon had a limited edition where they had the Jaguar XRK and other cars as well. So I wonder if there's a special edition of Need for Speed Underground 2. And what else? We have car audio and electronics opportunity.
Roll in front of the rest, and car audio and electronics may put your ride on their glossy.
Sweet. Oh yeah, we have a star event to do. I was gonna do that, wasn't I? We'll do the star event and the new RRs if this one is just a photo one. It is just a photo one. Sweet.
Just made their final edit, and you are in their next.
Wait, what? Oh yeah, cycle cameras. You want to try and get what? Nice. So wait, let's control the car for a bit. I want to try and head over to the next picture event. And this angle is so damn rubbish. Ow! Crap! All right, let's see if I can try and get a jump out of this. Hopefully I can, but this angle sucks. Whoa, how does that look? Looks shit. Okay. what can I really do? There's that. But I want to try and counter steer it, so it looks awesome. Try to get these camera angles sort of good. It's going to be a bit difficult. Oh yeah, I need to go this way as well. Yeah, this angle's okay for driving at the moment. Ow. Yeah, we're going to get a decent picture in a minute. Hopefully it won't take too long. I do like this picture editing though. It's kind of fun. How does that look? Yeah, that looks alright. Yay. And there's one just behind us as well. So might as well get that out of the way now. Oh, and there's a... Oh, nice, there's a hidden drift there as well.
You better get an agent.
Yes, we have better get an agent. Nice. So now, instead of doing that URI, we head to that hidden drift. And get more money. Because we can buy more stuff. Once we get our Lexus IS300. There we are. And, oh my, that's a long drift. Best reaction ever. Oh my. Probably gonna be. Imagine what that into like a horror movie. You like just see a massive load of bodies, just like oh my, and then just walk on normally. I just like that sometimes. You're like oh, it's artistic things. When something bad happens. Right, we're against a Supra, a 3000 GT, and an Infiniti G35? Yeah. Coming through. Yeah, I've been hitting into the wall too much. Right. Yeah, I'd say definitely drifting is definitely fun. I think the most thing you have to do is fishtail, mainly. Unlike Need for Speed Carbon, where you actually have to gain speed and drift properly. Right then. So I want to try and get ahead as most as possible. Plus I want the rip as well, so we can unlock more stuff. Even though rip wasn't as much, I think the rip was good in Need for Speed Underground 1. It based points off your style and how good you were racing. I think that was actually kind of a good solution on rip. And the drifts, oh my god, you can get so much rep in drifts in Need for Speed Underground 1. And I'd say the Subaru is definitely the perfect drifting car in that game. And in my opinion, I think it's still the best drift car in the Need for Speed Underground series. Right, one lap, 3-3. Okay. I want to try and actually lead ahead from these people. So I actually got the highest score and came first. There we are, we are finished! Could have got 90,000, but no, we never. Right, we got that. We got 300 rep, and that's always good. And I think I'll leave it off here. In this part, we took down a drift, a sprint, a circuit, a street X, a star event, and a partridge in a pear tree. And in the next episode, we'll be taking down a ULR race, doing some more stuff around stage 3, probably around more the stage 2, see? I keep forgetting what's called. It's not Beacon Hill. Fuck it, I'll remember it later. And probably, hopefully, do another UR race and unlock the licks. So I'll see you later. Take it easy.